finish looking.
DC. DC is it. We need to make that happen.
And through him, I wind up meeting another cat named Wayne Perry. Now, this kid here, he had the town on lock. And I mean, he had the town locked on fear.
DC in the early 1990s came to be known as the murder capital of the country.
They're saying the shooting is at 2nd in Maryland.
Okay, Alpo, you're the one going up New York and getting these keys and shit and coming back with them. But guess what? Your ass gonna sit right there, parked, sitting on them keys until Silk comes.
When people hear about Wayne Perry, 9 times out of 10, what comes to mind is hitman or killer.
When they mentioned his name, they mentioned murder in the same sentence, because he was about his work.
Yeah, animal, man.
Well respected.
Man, just known for not playing to leave you leaking.
I could have put my man Wayne from D.C. They don't know Wayne. Wayne would have walked right up on him, hit him 3 times, and then piss on him. Because D.C., they quick for their guns, man.
Okay.
They kill you in a minute, especially if they know you from out of town. I'm sitting up in there like, yo, what the hell am I going to do? I'm talking to my lawyer. My lawyer like, yo, your ace in the hole is Wayne Perry because they asking about him and this and that. I said, hold. Let's talk to him.
To see a person get on there and say, he did this, he did that when you was right with him. I don't condone that.
I hate rats. If you a rat, you need to die.
Because we always understood, if you do them wrong, this is part of the game. You want to party, hang with robbers and killers? Hold your water.
Can you give me more info on that call? Just clear another call.
You know, small as we are, 4 little sections of this other city, man. We was the murder capital of the world for like 3 years straight.
And while illegal drug use is found in every community, nowhere is it worse than our public housing projects.
Basically, projects is like Sodom and Gomorrah back in those days. You can't do what we used to do.
The 80s to the 90s, it just went crazy.
Wayne would do it in broad daylight. And dare you to snitch on
him. If it was time to put the murder game down, then that police description.
You know, that nigga killed.
So his bail was like, something I think I had to pay like 10%, which was like $10,000. I wound up giving up the whole $10,000, because I seen the bigger picture.
Right.
I said, if I get this kid out, then the reputation that he has, then all that'll come on my side.
Right.
Okay. Hell no, he didn't get me out. He had nothing to do with me getting out. But he gave me like $75,000. When he gave me this, and I get out. And so what is terrible about that American Jennings and Delta, you know, I was the first person that they broke. I was the very first person they wanted to do the very first story on me. That's what he said.
Right.
He sent me a list of all these people going to do it. I said, man, what is Miami Jennings about? They're never American Jennings.
At that point in his life, he became notorious.
Watching him and just hearing that name all the time. That's just like you hear your favorite superhero name all the time. In our hood, there's them the type of guys you look up to.
And that's why I'm targeting $50 million to fight crime in public housing projects, to help restore order, and for the kingpins, the death penalty.
And Wayne Perry was our king. You know, them dudes put their murder game down.
They swept the Southwest. They locked everybody up.
He was facing the death penalty, man. You know, they were trying to kill him, man. I watched him get that same loyalty that he gave me to an out-of-towner, man.
You know how the prosecution go. They can restructure it like you this capital killer.
Death before dishonor, he's been saying that for a long, long time.
But there is no match for a united America, a determined America, an angry America. We are going to win. Thank you. God bless.